can take in 2-3 questions now before we come to the conclusion of this session. If somebody has a question, please do raise your hand and maybe make it a specific question for the panelists that we intend. Yeah, the lady there, please.
Good evening, everyone. My question will be for Dr. Vinod K. Paul. So, sir, as you were discussing about Ayushman Bharat and all the benefits that are being offered under it, so it is often being observed that a part of our society is being left outside of availing the benefits that are being offered, so, and that is women. Women are often being observed that they restrain themselves from going for a health checkup. A woman will feel tired all day and she will not know that she's anemic. So in your view, sir, what are the ways to nudge people to actually go and have health services and avail the benefits that are being offered to them, especially women?
It's a valid point to an extent, and data do show that accessing services, particularly in secondary tertiary system, there is a skew toward men. So it's valid, and I also analyzed data in my previous avatar for newborn care. For every 2 boys, only 1 girl would come to the special care newborn units, the government newborn units in the district hospital. So it is indeed a fact that the care seeking by women for women is indeed an issue. Even children, female children, it is an issue. So I accept that. There are 2 ways to look at it now as a solution. One, that if the foundation of healthcare is primary healthcare, then we are very close to people. And therefore, there is an interesting opportunity and a vibrant opportunity to make sure that the women are engaged through the kind of mechanisms that Amadeus Sinhaji has set. And it does work. Because when you set out to do screening for universal screening, you're also looking for women as well as men. So it can be corrected. And the other part of this is to create what in Poshan Abhiyan we have called Jan Andolan, that there is a participation of community as a whole toward an endeavor. And that endeavor can be generic, but can also be specific. For example, something around breast cancer screening. So you create a movement that should be, or for anemia, which 50% women are anemic. So I would, while accepting this bias, which is indeed a problem, it's a societal problem, there are ways within the health system and across our other sectors and society that we should correct them. Tomorrow, is there something that we need to do for women to get them connected to secondary tertiary care? If there is that kind of a gap, let's say for specific illnesses where women are truly not coming, say heart disease, for example, heart disease surgery, for example, or congenital heart disease in girls, we could think about other means and ways of incentivizing that or creating facilitatory pathway. We need solutions in this regard. This is a problem. It's a social determinant of lack of access, but we will find a way and we expect ideas on this one. Thank you for making that point.
Is there another question here?
My question is for Dr. Paul. You said that Ayushman Bharat is presently for the people of the lowest percentile of our population. So how this scheme will help the people above that percentile, say in the near future?
Good point. So please remember, who is the most needy in our country? You stack them up in a certain way, and the ones more at the bottom you are, more needy you are. So in a very, I would say, in the right manner, respecting the rights of people and the needs of the marginalized, the leadership, the Honorable Prime Minister and the Cabinet and the Parliament and all of us, together decided that let us first work with this 40% of India's population which are stacked right below. We'll also find ways of addressing the next, you know, remaining 60%. The 40% middle belly is the middle classes. And the 10% on top, they don't need your help. The top quintile are rich people, 5 crore families, they don't need your help. They're all protected, they are government servant, they are rich people, and so on. So the middle belly at the moment has been left out from this arrangement. But think of a scenario. if this program was opened even for them, let's say it was opened for 60% of India's population, 80% of India's population, be rest assured that experience and the dynamics and common sense tells us that these people who were the most needy would not have been able to even stand in the queue. They will be pushed all the way, mile away in the queue. So I think it is sagacity of the political system of India. They said, go with them, make them aware of their rights, create a system around them, let them get used to the benefits that they have, and then we'll find ways of doing it. And indeed, Niti Aayog, as you know from newspapers, we are working as to how now the other two quintiles, in particular, leave the top quintile, have to be addressed, and we are looking at all options, including making it tax-based as it is now, or looking at contributory partly as it works in some systems. So we are actively looking at how the middle classes have to be engaged. And the last one on this is that state like Himachal, state like Maharashtra, Telangana, they are already including all the people, and that is what I said, the states have gone further adding people. So there are also interesting opportunities where state, if they have resources and they have the will, they are willing to do it. But in terms of, in principle designing of the study, we are actively looking at how the middle belly, the middle classes, should now become part of the universal health coverage. But having given the priority to the most needy was
right.
Morally and, you know, morally as well as politically and economically, the right decision and support. I think.